Cry Freedom Soundbite number 55. Sunday, the 25th of February, 2018. Just to reiterate, these soundbites are a recording of my honest and open thoughts and feelings at this very special time in the reality or non-reality of this existence, merely a way for me to document the feelings that I personally am experiencing at this time. To make of what you will. The weekend, probably one of the most nefarious parts of the week if you look at it in a certain way. To do with the sat and the sun. The weekend. All these words and double meanings, and it's a time when everything has different meanings, and there are many different meanings and many different ways and many different interpretations. I've certainly got a lot of them going around in my head at the minute as I lie here on what is a very cold morning. The old ice fairy's been going mad today. Especially where I am, as I lie in my bed trying to stay cosy and realizing that the slightest little chink open to the outside lets in a lot of external coldness and penetrates the warmth that I'm trying to build up within. And I'm just looking at the allegory within all of this and how life is one big allegory, and that certainly is one to me. And I'm starting to see more and more that the more of the external that we let in, then quite often the colder it will become. And I think that the more external that we do let in, the more we are giving away the power from deep within us and opening ourselves up to all sorts of disappointments and a lot more. That's what I keep getting back to for whatever reason. There's one side of me that says this is just a very paranoid, critical way of looking at things, and there's another part of me that says, well, actually, we live in a very paranoid, critical place that seems to be intent on evil at every turn. So how could we not feel that way? And so it's like almost a protection, an inner protection of yourself by not allowing any of that external crap to penetrate. And that's making a lot of sense to me this morning as I lie here in my warmish bed in the cold. So last night I was listening to the man of the moment, it seems, one Jordan Peterson, in an interview with Russell Brand on his Under the Skin show, very aptly named again. And it was an interesting interview. It was good to listen to. It was enlightening. It was, if you look at it in a certain way, it was hope instilling with regards to believing that there are good things going on out there with people that seem to care. But then again, maybe that's what it was meant to come across as. Again, this is the paranoia slipping in slightly. At this point in time, when we're working up to a climax in history, his story, a climax in his story. You could go on with this forever, couldn't you? Because I've been listening to a lot of John Pinella recently, and his views, which are somewhat paranoid, shall we say, but then again, we live in what is completely a paranoid place, so how could we not be? And he would say that we are, as we have been for so long, in the middle of a giant deception that is heading to the ultimate deception. And that would be that, okay, so he says that there's two trees, okay? There's the tree of knowledge and there's the tree of life. The tree of knowledge is very much a contrived tree that has been set to trick us in many ways, and is made up of two forces of evil, it seems. A bad and a bad good. Make of that what you will. But all of it ultimately is sent to trick us and use us and abuse us. Then there is the tree of life, which he says is the true tree of real depth of meaning and everything that matters that should be, and the tree that we should be following, but that we've been tricked not to by this tree of knowledge which has taken over and which people believe is the right tree. So again, it's all about the fruit of which tree you shake, right? So the tree of knowledge relates back to, as I said, as he says, two forces of evil, and one is a controlling evil here upon this so-called reality, whatever that is. And the other is a higher form of control that is in the as above part, I suppose. So it's here below and as above, right? Now the here below is, I'm going to start using religious terms again here, but only because that's what he uses. The Bible is, if you ignore the manufactured religious side of the Bible, it is a book of knowledge, in fact. So if we interpret it that way and by using the names within it, not because we're being religious, but just because they're the names that are used. So this below part is controlled evilly and run by Satan, okay? The definitions of the Christmas tree within what John Pinnell is saying as well. Wow, you'd never have one of the things again, ever. It's all tied in. Every little bit of it is tied in, deliberately. And we all worship this idol of evil without even knowing it. But then again, you could look at it from the view that if you're not worshipping it from that evil point of view and you're doing it from something you believe is good, then with the power of the mind, does that not make a difference anyway? This goes on and on and on. So many different ways of viewing it. But anyway, so if we're talking about Satan, who's been running this little part of the hellhole for a long, 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 long time, and he has been doing it as sort of the second in command, because the ultimate force of evil from up above is Lucifer. That this is where the sun all gets tied in. The so-called light bearer, there again are many connotations of the word Lucifer, and what John says is happening at the moment is that essentially he says that the New World Order was never meant to be. It was a controlling faction that was doing a job as second in command to lead up to a certain point, and it was never actually meant to happen, because right at the end, the ultimate evil, who has to have the glory and come back and show himself and expose himself, so to speak, comes back into this false reality and wields his rod of iron, as was always intended, and we enter the One World Order instead of the New World Order, none of which is good, essentially, for humanity. So this is everything that I've been looking at with regards to what John Pinella says. It's very difficult to know exactly where to go and how to think. So again, we get back to the same thing. I think that in some ways it's almost like we're being built up to believe again in something that could be real and something that could be good after so much negativity and disappointment and frustration and anger and all those things that go with the way you feel when you see what's happening. And it's almost like the ultimate last temptation of good to slap us back down in the face in the biggest way we could ever be slapped back down. That's how it kind of feels, and I know that's a very, very negative way of looking at it, but I'm just trying to be realistic with everything that's come my way over the last decade or so, and it kind of makes sense. It's not what I want to believe. I want to believe that there is someone out there who's going to make a difference, and we know who we're talking about here without me having to say the name. I want to believe that there is actually a change taking place, and it deems hope for us all, but that's my heart. With my head, I find that difficult to believe. And my head is telling me that a lot of what John Pinella is saying makes absolute sense, even though I don't really want to believe it. But that said, if this is all a false reality anyway, then surely the most important thing is to see it for what it really is. And we get back again to the going within bit, that if you are able to do that and switch off from anything external other than as an observer, because it cannot be argued that these are not interesting times, if you can step back and switch the heart off and just watch what's happening, because either way it's not going to really make any difference to the final outcome, so you might as well watch it and kind of enjoy it. It's almost like the old George Carlin way of thinking. I mean, he made a lot of sense, obviously, didn't he, good old George? But stand back and watch the show whilst remaining true to yourself in every way that you can, and doing the best you can for people in your sphere, and just trying to be a good person and a nice person that makes a difference. That, to me, is the only way that I find I can look at things now. And I'm not wading in despair here, no, far from it. I've gone past that one. But I'm not going to give myself away to something that just looks good for that very reason, that it probably isn't as good as it might look, or as good as we might want to believe. I'm not going to give that away anymore, so. But I shall remain doing the best I can, in whatever way I can, however small that may seem. every little touch makes a difference. And I think that's the important thing to remember at all times. So this is a positive message. Be aware. Don't be tricked. Don't put yourself in a position where you can be crushed back down again. I think that's probably, in essence, what I'd say I've learned during all of this. So there you go. Heavy stuff for a Sunday, but then again, as I say, Sunday is quite a relevant day. So until next time.